First thing you want to do is unscrew the four bolts that are under here. So I got a Phillips screwdriver and I unscrew them. Next, what you want to do is get a needle. Once you unscrew these four bolts, make sure you take out the gas out of the carburetor, because if you don't take out the gas, it's going to start leaking gas and you don't want that. I have this right here, which is like a drain thing for the gas. So if I flip it upside down, it drains it. Once you unscrew the four bolts on the bottom, this should pop right off. And this is what my thing looks like. I just put the carburetor on the ground right now. You should have some gas in here. I already took the gas out. And you don't want to lose your gasket, because I already ripped one gasket and it costed me $6 to replace it. So we'll just put your gasket aside. For this, I'm going to put it on top of my dirt bike. Next, as you can see, I still have gas in here, so I want to clean that out. I have a mini can right here. I'm going to pour the extra of the gas out. As you can see, there's some dirt in here that I need to clean out so the carburetor could work better. So what you need is some cotton swabs and some air swabs. I'll be back and I'll show you what I do next. Hey guys, I came back and I got three cotton swabs. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get the cotton swabs, get some gas on them. As you can see, I did my first wipe and it's already pretty dirty. So I wanna clean out the bottom of my carb. Just clean out the bottom and everything. You don't want dirt in your carb, that's what clogs it up. So it also ruins it. You see, it's pretty dirty. So once you're done cleaning that, what you need is a flathead screwdriver. So now what you want to do, this is the main jet and this is the pilot jet. What you want to do is unscrew them. I got a flathead screwdriver right here. Want to unscrew the main jet. Also, this just popped out of mine. It's just a thing, the pin that holds your float bowl. It's the pin that holds your float. Just pop it back in. And once you loosened it, your main jet, this is what mine looks like. Yours might look different, but it has holes on the side. So what I did is I went and got a needle, and I'll show you what to do next. So I have my needle right here. I don't know if you guys can see it. It's pretty dang small. So what I'm gonna do is poke my needle through every hole. And that's to make sure there's nothing in there. I'm gonna do that to all the holes. Because if there's something in here that's blocking it, that's probably one reason why your bike won't start. And then there should be a hole in the bottom. I'm gonna poke through. Also, you could get it and blow through it, like I'm about to do right now. If you start blowing and you hear a noise, that's good, because if you hear the air going through, that's good. That means it's not clogged. So, now what I want to do is put my main jet back. Or actually, get a cotton swab and clean out the inside of this. That's pretty dirty. That's pretty dirty. Then you just want to just clean it out, make sure it won't get dirty. Now just clean it out, get as clean as you can. Then you want to put the main jet back. You don't want to over tighten it. that, I'm just gonna tighten it a little bit. Then you'll also want to unscrew your pilot jet. Your pilot jet is like the smaller version of the main jet. It also has holes. So you want to get your needle again and poke it through. And there should be a hole on the bottom. I'm gonna poke it through too. The hole's not big enough for the needle, so just try going through as much as you can. You don't want to get the needle stuck in here. Then you want to do the same thing, is get the cotton swab. Get the cotton swab and clean out the pilot jet. It doesn't fit in there that good, but try getting as much dirt as you can out. Also, what you want to do is clean out the outside of the carburetor. Have you seen that? That's pretty dirty. Okay guys, I just got done cleaning, and as you can see, the cotton swab is not clean at all. Carburetor is much cleaner now. I just cleaned it out. Also, before you don't want to put the carburetor in dry, so you want to get some gas. I still have a little gas in here. You want to get the gas, get a cotton swab, and just spread it around in the carburetor. Or if you have like a spray bottle, you can spray it in there. And I forgot to put my pilot jet back in. Good thing I noticed that. Let's screw the pilot jet in. Screwdriver right here. I don't tighten it that much because I don't want to strip the threads. Just clean it in. And then for the bottom piece, also add some gas. I'm gonna add some more gas. And you should be good. Don't forget about your gasket. If your gasket fell off, my gasket goes on in a special direction. And I don't want to keep my gasket dry, so I'll add some gas on that too. Just add it on the outside. Because if you have a dry gasket, it could start cracking and then rip. You don't want that to happen. Like I said before, they're pretty expensive. You think they're cheap, but they're actually not that cheap. So it goes on like that. Now this is what it should look like with the gasket on. It took me a while to put this on. Now what you want to do is find out which way the carburetor goes on. I have it perfect right now. I'm gonna look around and make sure to know where the gasket pops out. Then I'll put the screws in. I don't want to tighten one screw automatically and then just want to keep that one loose and do it all around until I have all four screws and do it evenly. Two more screws to go. this one. Don't tighten all of them at the same time. So now I'm going to mount the air filter. This is like the basically an adapter from the air filter to the carburetor. It ripped right here, so I put some Loctite glue on here. Not the Loctite super glue, but the Loctite rubber glue. Put it around and now it looks better. Also on the inside. So the airflow won't get weak. Then you want to just mount it on here. Like I just did. Make sure it's even on all sides. Then what you want to do is get the air filter. You have the air filter. That's just a cover paper, but the air filter looks pretty new once you take it off. Then you want to do is just pop the air filter right on. Or should pop on. And you know if it'll pop on correctly, it spins. And you always want to make sure it's even on all sides. My air filter came with one of these, so now I'm going to unscrew it. Unscrew it with the screwdriver and put it back on the air filter. And now I'm going to pop it on the air filter. Filter, tighten it. Make sure it's nice and tight. But your filter should still move. And now what I'm going to show you is how to mount it. So mine came with two bolts. And I have two of these. I want to unscrew them. And so now it goes the carburetor on first, or actually the gasket. It goes gasket, the rubber side, onto the rubber side. It should be like that. And you want to hold it with your finger. Or just do this. Do that. Put the gasket through. And then put the other nut through. That's why I do mine. It doesn't matter how you do yours, as long as you're not missing the gasket. Then you just put it through like that. I don't know if you guys can see it, but I put mine through. Now what you want to do is place the nut on the end. Hand tighten it. And then do the same thing with the other side. What you want to do is I have a 5/16 head with a 3/8 adapter so it could be longer. Put it through and tighten it like that. Do the same thing to the other side. Tighten it with your hand and just tighten it like this. Again, you don't want to over-tighten it, because the gasket in my hair can crack. Make sure you go down, and you want to twist the cap on. Like so. You don't have to do it right now, you could do it with the carburetor off. A lot more fuel. So now there's fuel in the carburetor, and it should be good. And that's how I clean out my Mikuni carburetor. Thanks for watching, guys. Please like and subscribe.